which is probably one of the smallest chambers of commerce in the world, I suspect. Katamir is passionate about minimizing the use of plastic bags and is going to tell us her story. Please welcome Katamir.
My name is Katamir and I'm the administrator for the Raglan Chamber of Commerce in Aotearoa, New Zealand. Lower. Better? Yeah? Okay. I forgot to wear my glasses this morning, so we'll see how we get through this. This is a plastic bag found lying around at Manu Bay in Raglan, Aotearoa, New Zealand, one of the top surfing spots in the South Pacific. This is also a plastic bag, found in the Raglan Harbor, where a few times throughout the year, we are treated to a pod of orcas who chase the stingray in from the sea. Whangaroa Raglan is a small seaside town on the west coast of the North Island of New Zealand. Known for its world-class surf breaks, it has grown to become one of the top tourist destinations in the country, with visitors now taking advantage of the water that surrounds Raglan in multiple ways. At any time of year, kayaks can be found in the harbor, and families can be found fishing at the wharf while surfers dot the lineup from the beach to the famed Raglan points. As a chamber, our mission is to support, foster, and advocate for vibrant and sustainable business, both economically and environmentally in Whangaroa Raglan. So when the Whangaroa Environment Center approached the Raglan Chamber to gauge the board's interest in supporting the removal of single-use plastic bags from our community, there was very little hesitation. Our main street runs straight into the harbor, with the closest shops sitting less than 50 footsteps away from the water. Like many other towns, we have our share of infrastructure issues due to the rapid growth of tourism. While most of those issues are left up to our councils to solve, the Chamber acknowledged that the more tangible concerns, like rubbish blowing into the sea, was something actually within our own control to change. Tasked with an ever-growing tourist destination and operating within a community who prides itself on being environmentally friendly, we realized that the economic health and well-being of our businesses is essentially influenced by the environmental health of our community and the wild, beautiful spaces that attract our visitors. In Te Reo Māori, we say, toi tū a Papatūānuku, toi tū a Tangaroa, toi tū te tangata. If the land is well and the sea is well, the people will thrive. And so, Plastic Bag Free Raglan was created at the beginning of 2016. Known more formally as PBFR, the project is made up of a team of three and a steering committee that includes members of the Raglan Chamber, the Whangaroa Environment Center, our refuse and recycling company, Extreme Zero Waste, local Māori not-for-profit organization, Parakore, and members of the Raglan Community Board. The mission of Plastic Bag Free Raglan is to become a single-use plastic bag free community by July of 2019. In order to better understand what our business community thought about going plastic bag free, our first task was to conduct a survey. Through email and in-person conversations, we found that of the 45 businesses providing plastic bags, 60% supported becoming a single-use plastic bag free business. We also found that our small seaside town was using upwards of 20,000 single-use plastic bags per week. Simultaneously, we were conducting a community survey. Would the residents of Whangaroa Raglan continue to support businesses who removed their single-use plastic shopping bags? 92% of survey takers plainly and simply stated yes. From there, the real work began, and little did we actually know how much work that would end up being. For those of you who have never been to Raglan, Raglan is home to about 3,500 people year-round, but on any given holiday weekend or during the high summer season, the temporary population of our community can drastically increase to 10,000. Taking this into consideration, we realized that not only would we have to work with the businesses and our own residents, but also the visitors. We compiled a list of accommodation providers and created the PBFR accommodation package, which includes a small poster, a fact sheet about single-use plastic bags, a list of businesses supporting the Plastic Bag Free Initiative, and in some cases, we also provided a reusable bag that could be kept in the accommodation and used by visitors. These resources were distributed to the 30 main accommodation providers and the Tourist Information Center prior to the busy summer season. During this process, we were also working quietly to organize a small gift for the residents of Raglan. After hearing concerns from some of the residents about not having a reusable bag to use for their shopping, PBFR applied for funding from the Waikato District Council and the Waikato Regional Council. And in November of 2016, we were able to deliver 2,500 genuinely environmentally friendly jute shopping bags to local residents. To further address community concerns, a small volunteer sewing group was established in July of 2016 called Bag It Raglan. These volunteers meet monthly to sew reusable shopping bags using donated fabric, and the bags are provided free of charge to the community. To date, the group has made over 1,000 reusable bags. The Bag It bags, along with the jute bags, have become staples of Raglan and a favorite amongst visitors to take back to their country or send home to family and friends. One visitor loved the idea of the Bag It sewing group so much that he made a short documentary film about it. We recently found out that the film was screened at the Kaiupanakuai Environmental Short Film Festival in Lima, Peru. In April of this year, Plastic Bag Free Raglan, with support from the Raglan Chamber, created and distributed the business support booklet, which was followed by the launch of the PBFR accreditation program in May. The accreditation program is open to all businesses who are not supplying single-use plastic shopping bags. If they are a business that does not have takeaways like an accounting office or a mechanic shop, but they encourage the use of reusable bags and support the mission of Plastic Bag Free Raglan, they are still able to be a certified partner. Since the launch of the accreditation program, Plastic Bag Free Raglan has certified over 60 businesses as official PBFR partners, with 20 of those businesses officially removing single-use plastic bags from their stores. And on September 1st, one of our largest providers of single-use plastic carry bags, the Raglan Foursquare Supermarket, became the first Foursquare in New Zealand to go plastic bag free and now provides a 100% truly compostable carry bag and boxes as an alternative for their customers. While the focus of Plastic Bag Free Raglan has been on single-use plastic bags, some of the businesses in our community have taken it upon themselves to go a step further and are working to remove single-use plastic waste where they can, transitioning to compostable takeaways for food and paper straws for their drinks, inspiring a unique social responsibility within our small business community. Although the accomplishments of PBFR have been positive overall, there have been curveballs and plenty of bumps along the way. One of the biggest challenges we have faced is finding an alternative solution for businesses. While the long-term vision of PBFR is to see shoppers bringing their own reusable bag, we also know that shops need to have something on hand in case a customer forgets. The supply chain for truly compostable bags is immature, and the cost of these bags is astronomical compared to plastic bags. So unless a business were to get rid of their bags altogether, some just cannot afford to make the switch. This issue continues to be one of our top KPIs. As the plastic bag free movement gains momentum around the world and the impact of single-use plastic waste continues to grow, I implore you, our fellow chamber members, to look at your own communities and take note of the environmental health surrounding your businesses. I am not here to deliver the facts about the amount of plastic bags being used around the world today, or to convince you that every piece of plastic ever created still exists on the earth in some form. But I will go as far as suggesting that the implementation of sustainable business practices can only strengthen the long-term vitality of communities, both economically and environmentally. Toitū a papatūānuku. Toitū a tangaroa, toitū te tangata. If the land is well and the sea is well, the people will thrive. Kia ora and thank you.
Thank you for sharing it, and from little acorns, huge trees grow, and I'm watching that one.